The painting I'm going to share with you today is relating to confession and divine mercy. And it's based on a painting I did, an earlier version of some years ago, called The Tribunal of Mercy. And it really tries to demonstrate how confession is the great sacrament of divine mercy, and how the priest, when he absolves the sinner, Jesus and his divine mercy is there absolving the sinner. As we find many times in the diary of Saint Faustina, Jesus would refer to the sacrament of confession as his tribunal of divine mercy, where the greatest miracles take place. And this, the original painting I did some years ago, it was called The Tribunal of Mercy. And in this version was a commission by a priest, Father Andrew Grace, in Sacred Heart Parish in New South Wales, in Griffith. And the original painting is 2.5 meters wide by 1.5 meters tall, a very large painting. And he asked me to paint Padre Pio, St. Pio of Pietrelcina, as the priest in confession, administering absolution to the soul in confession. Because it's a very Italian community in Griffith, and he thought many of them have a great devotion to St. Pio, to Padre Pio, so he would like this saint to be depicted in the painting. So I began work on this about the middle of last year, 2017, and I was just about, I had the canvas delivered to the home, the very large canvas, and I had all the preliminary drawings and everything completed. I knew how I was going to sketch the painting in. And just as I was about to start the work, I play soccer at home, and a game of soccer, I got an injury in the back and contracted a really severe, acute case of sciatica. And I'm sure any of you who have suffered from that kind of pain, you'll know exactly what that feels like. And it basically immobilized me for about 2 months. I couldn't do anything. I could hardly walk. I couldn't sleep. I couldn't stand. And I couldn't do any painting at all. And so I began to reflect on this. What was God trying to show me through this suffering that I seemed to be going through? And I needed to work. He wanted me to do this work, so why is he stopping me from doing this? And in my frustration and desperation, I began to think and pray more about why this was happening. And I began to think, well, Padre Pio was a great saint, a great priest, saint of the confessional. And he's one who suffered greatly throughout his life. He bore the wounds of Christ in his body, the stigmata, for 50 years. And he spent countless hours hearing the confessions of souls throughout his life. And so I thought, well, if he suffered to bring souls to Christ, maybe God is, in his own way, wanting me to share in a little bit of his physical sufferings in order to bring grace through this painting. I also thought of the words of the great patron saint of sacred art, Blessed Fra Angelico, the patron saint of sacred art, who once said that in order to depict Christ, he was a painter himself, he said, in order to depict Christ, one must live with Christ. And so these words became very much my own reflection as I approached this painting. And I thought maybe that little bit of suffering God can use in a powerful way. So I offered that suffering and slowly, gradually began to recover and got my strength back and then began work on the painting. Confession for the soul, Jesus said, the greatest miracles take place in divine mercy through the sacrament of reconciliation. And I would say probably three words that we all should hear in life, and it's three very precious words. If it's said by a brother, a sister, a mother, a father, or a spouse, and those three words are, I love you. But there are three other words, or a whole sentence, which if we ever hear, it's the greatest words we will ever hear this side of eternity. And those words are, I absolve you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So I would encourage each and every one of you to use this painting as a meditation, a reflection on a great sacrament of divine mercy and confession. I would now like to present you, with any luck, with sound and vision this time, hopefully, please God, the Fountain of Mercy. Thank you very much. God bless you.